the deep flexor compartment of the forearm. The forearm is the region of the upper limb between the elbow joint, shown proximally, and the wrist joint, distally. There are two long bones in the forearm. The radius lies laterally under the thumb. The ulnar lies medially under the little finger. The forearm is divided into two compartments by the interosseous membrane and the deep fascia. The anterior compartment contains the superficial flexors and the deep flexors. The posterior compartment contains the extensors and the mobile wad of three. There are three deep flexors of the forearm: flexor digitorum profundus, flexor pollicis longus, and pronator quadratus. In contrast to the superficial flexors, all of the deep flexor muscles arise distal to the elbow joint, and so therefore they do not cause any movement at the elbow joint. Deep flexors, flexor digitorum profundus. This muscle arises from the proximal three quarters of the ulnar and the interosseous membrane. It inserts by a slender tendon onto the distal phalanges of the fingers. It works by flexing the distal interphalangeal joints of the fingers. Flexor pollicis longus. This muscle arises from the radius and the interosseous membrane. It inserts via a long slender tendon onto the distal phalanx of the thumb. It flexes the thumb at the interphalangeal joint. Pronator quadratus. This arises from the distal quarter of the ulnar. It inserts onto the distal quarter of the radius. As its name suggests, it pronates the forearm. This diagram shows a cross-section through the middle of the forearm. At the top of the diagram is the anterior or volar surface. At the bottom is the posterior or dorsal surface. To the left is lateral, and to the right is medial. Just below the skin is the subcutaneous fat. This is a cross-section through the ulnar bone, shown medially, the interosseous membrane, and the radius more laterally. The extensor compartment is shown near the posterior or dorsal surface. The mobile wad of three is placed laterally, also within the posterior compartment. The flexor compartment can be seen towards the top or the anterior surface. The deep flexors are closest to the bones, and the superficial flexors are closer to the skin. Medially is the flexor digitorum profundus. Laterally is the flexor pollicis longus, adjacent to the radius. All muscles of the deep flexor compartment are supplied by the anterior interosseous nerve, which is a branch of the median nerve, except for the medial half of flexor digitorum profundus. The tendons of the medial half of flexor digitorum profundus attach to the little and ring fingers. This part of the muscle is supplied by the ulnar nerve. You're